So good morning everyone. Today I am going to discuss corrosion under the chapter free energy in chemical equilibrium. So what is corrosion? I think all of you have heard the term corrosion. I also heard the term rusting of iron, that will be explained today. So what is corrosion? The most common type of iron occurs when it is exposed to oxygen and the presence of water. So we need metals, iron, we have oxygen, now we have presence of water vapor, which creates red iron oxides, commonly called rust. Okay. Rust can also affect iron alloys such as steel. The rusting of iron can also occur when iron reacts with chloride in an oxygen deprived environment, while green rust, which is another type of corrosion, can be formed directly from metallic iron or iron hydroxide. So this process is a reduction oxidation reaction in which metal is being oxidized by its surroundings, often the oxygen in air. This reaction is both spontaneous and electrochemically favored. That means del G is negative. So what is the corrosion? So in order to get corroded, you need metals, we need oxygen, we need presence of water vapor. So most common type of iron corrosion occur when it is exposed to oxygen and presence of water, which creates a red iron oxide commonly called rust. Okay. Rust can also affect iron alloys such as steel. The rusting of iron can also occur when iron reacts with chlorine in an oxygen deprived environment. While green rust, which is another type of corrosion, can be formed directly from metallic iron or iron hydroxide. So this process is a redox reactions in which metal is being oxidized. I have already discussed in the previous video lecture what is oxidation reductions, oxidizing agent, reducing agents. Okay, so being oxidized by its surroundings, often the oxygen in air. This reaction is both spontaneous and electrochemically favored. Now what is the cause of corrosion? Metal corrodes when it reacts with another substance such as oxygen, hydrogen, and electrical current, or even dirt and bacteria. Corrosion can also happen when metals like steels are placed under too much stress, causing a material to crack. Metals are electropositive in nature. Okay, we have already discussed this thing in periodic table, except a few such as gold and platinum are noble metals, and other metals are found to exist in nature as their compounds such as oxides, hydroxides, carbonates, chlorides, sulfates, phosphates, nitrates, silicates. Okay, so this is the cause. Cause means maybe metal corrodes with reaction with another substance, oxygen, hydrogen, or electrical current, or even dirt and bacteria. Corrosion can also happen when metals like steel are placed under too much stress, causing material to crack. Metals are electropositive in nature, except a few such as gold and platinum or noble metals. Other metals are also found to exist in nature as a compound of oxides, hydroxides, carbonates, chlorides, sulfides, phosphates, nitrates, silicates, etc. When extracted from ore, these metal ions are converted into metal atoms by reduction process, and that has high energy and unstable. So these are main three components necessary to corrosion. So what are the main components to bring about the corrosion? First, metal. As an example, iron. Number two, oxygen, usually from the atmosphere. Number three, an electrolyte, usually water. Okay, so this particular reagents should be recalled to bring about the corrosions. Okay. So now types of corrosions. There are so many corrosions. Okay. So first one is uniform corrosions. Uniform corrosion means this is the most common form of corrosions which usually takes place evenly over large areas of material surface. This is the most common form of corrosions which usually takes place even over large areas of material surface. So that's types of corrosions occurs when a metal throughout the metal surface. Number three, pitting corrosions. This localized type of corrosions happen when local anodic or cathodic points form corrosions shell with surrounding surface. So cathodic, anodic, half shell of oxidation, reduction half shell oxidation, that will be discussed later in galvanic shell. So this pit can create a hole or cavity which typically penetrates the material in a vertical directions down from the surface. So that is the pitting corrosions. Next, move on the slide. Next, crevice corrosions. So this form of corrosion occurs in areas where oxygen is restricted. That type of corrosions occur in areas where oxygen is restricted, such as under washer or bolt heads. These localized corrosions, washer or bolt, we have seen that corrosions or rust. These localized corrosions usually results from difference in the iron concentrations between two areas of metal. The stagnant micro environment prevents circulation of oxygen, which stops repassivations and cause a buildup of stagnant solutions, moving the pH balance away from neutral. So that depends on the pH corrosions also. From the neutral, it deviates from neutral, you know, pH 7, less than 7, it is acidic, and more than 7, it is basic. So that is the crevice corrosions. Okay. Number four is intergranular corrosions. Intergranular corrosions occurs when impurities are present at grain boundaries, which form during solidification of an alloy. So that type of intergranular corrosions occurs when impurities are present at the grains boundary, which form during solidifications of an alloy. It can also be caused by enrichment or depletion of alloying element at the grain boundaries. So that is the intergranular corrosions. Next, number five, trace corrosion cracking, SCC. It is known as a SCC. Trace corrosion cracking refers to growth of cracks due to corrosive environment, which can lead due to corrosive, maybe base, maybe alkali or acids. Okay, so release of toxic metals, chemicals. Stress corrosion cracking refers to the growth of the crack due to corrosive environment, which can lead to the failure of ductile metals when subject to tensile stress, particularly at high temperature. So that type of corrosions refers to the growth of cracks due to the corrosive environment, which can lead to the failure of ductile metals when subject to tensile stress, particularly at high temperature. Now, apart from this classification, division of corrosion, although there are so many classification that will be discussed next slides, again we have seen that corrosion also is kind of two types, which is very important: chemical corrosions and electrochemical corrosions. Chemical corrosions occurs in the dry state. chemical corrosion occurs in the dry state, whereas electrochemical corrosion occurs in the presence of moisture, that is vapor. So chemical corrosion occurs in the dry state, electrochemical corrosion occurs in presence of moisture. It involves direct chemical attack of the metal by environment. So in case of chemical corrosion, it involves direct chemical attack of the metal by environment. But in case of electrochemical corrosion, it involves the setting up of large number of tiny galvanic cell. So you know galvanic cell, oxygen, cathode, anode, that will be discussed in the next letter. So it involves the setting up of large number of tiny galvanic cell. So next, chemical corrosion, even homogeneous surface will be corroded. In case of chemical corrosion, even homogeneous surface will be corroded. Heterogeneous surface or presence of impurity in metal, an important conditions for this type of corrosion. Corrosion product accumulates in area where corrosion occurs. Corrosion occurs at anode, while the corrosion product accumulates at the cathode. Generally uniform corrosion occurs in case of chemical corrosion. Here generally pitting corrosion occurs more frequently. So in case of chemical corrosion, generally uniform corrosion occurs. In case of electrochemical corrosion, pitting corrosion occurs more frequently. Examples: formation of mean scale iron, reaction of dry HCl, it should be HCl. HCl gas on Fe, fogging of nickel in SO2 atmosphere. Example, rusting of iron in moist atmosphere, cracking of iron due to stress corrosions, zincification of brass, etc. So these are the examples of chemical corrosion and electrochemical corrosion. That is also very important. Next, galvanic corrosion. Galvanic corrosion, this form of corrosion occurs when two different metals with physical or electrical contact are immersed in common electrolyte such as salt water, while more active metal, that is anode, corrodes first than the more noble metal, that is cathode. Again I tell you, the galvanic corrosion, this form of corrosion occurs when two different metals with physical or electrical contact, are immersed in common electrolyte such as salt water, while more active metal, that is anode, corrode faster than the more noble metals, that is cathode. Okay, so that is the galvanic corrosion. Next is rusting of iron. You know, this is very, very important. So both internal and final exam. Pure iron does not rust. When impure iron is left in moist air, it is covered by a reddish brown layer called rust. Pure iron does not rust. When impure iron is left in moist air, it is covered by a, it should be small a, reddish brown layer called rust. Rust is due to formation of tiny galvanic cell in which impurities act as anode and pure iron acts as a cathode and water as a electrolyte. Again I tell you, pure iron does not rust. Okay. when impure iron is left in moist air, it is covered by a reddish brown layer called rust. Rust is due to the formation of tiny galvanic shell in which impurity acts as anode and pure iron acts as a cathode and water as a electrolyte. Okay, look this picture. See, this is the water, this is iron, this is the anodic side, this is the cathodic side. Okay, so this is the atmosphere. In atmosphere we have seen that there is a rust. Okay, so how it is formed? You see, rust formula Fe2O3.x water. Okay, that is the formula of rust. Now what will happen? Fe2+ in the presence of oxygen and also water vapor, what will happen? We will get the rusting of iron. So this is the anodic side, this is the cathodic side. Okay, now Fe solid, which dissociated into Fe2+ aqueous plus twice electron. Now similarly, O2 take up that proton, 4H+ ions become 4 electron plus twice H2O. So that is the schematically diagram of rust. How does rust is formed? So how the rust is formed? So that is the explanation. You see, these three component, water, metals and oxygen, so we get the rust. Okay, so that is the anodic side, that is the cathodic side. Now oxidation at anode, what will happen? Fe goes to Fe2+ twice electron. Reduction at cathode, 2H+ twice electron. We know oxidation means loss of electron, reduction means gain of electrons. We get 2H. Okay, comma, again 2H reacts with half O2 to form water molecules. Again half 2H+ reacts with half O2, we plus 2 electron, we get water. So in this way, that is the formation of water and also generation of H+. So net reaction H+ and half O2 plus Fe, we get Fe2+ plus water. Now Fe2+ ions so formed move through water and reacts at the surface of iron, reacts with surface of iron, where these are oxidized to Fe3+ ions by atmospheric oxygen that constitute the rust, which is hydrated ferric oxides. So what I have told you, Fe2+ plus half O2 plus water will get Fe2O3 plus 4H+ dot Fe2O3 plus X water. Okay, from this we get Fe2O3 X water, that is the rust. That is the rust. So presence of carbon dioxide increase the rate of formation of rust. Presence of carbon dioxide, they increase the rate of formation of rust. We know carbon dioxide reacts, we get carbonic acid HCO3, or we get H2CO3. So similarly H+ HCO3-. So that is the corrosion prevention. Okay, so next, the corrosion prevention, that is corrosion prevention. Number one, use of non-corrosive metals such as stainless steel or aluminium. Number two, make sure that metal surface stays clean and dry. Use drying agents. Use a coating barrier product such as grease, oil, painter or carbon fiber coating, coal tar, paint, varnish, etc. So corrosion prevention, how will you prevent corrosion? First, use of non-corrosive metals such as stainless steel, aluminium, okay. Number two is make sure the metal surface stay clean and dry, okay. Number three, use drying agents. Number four, use a coating or barrier product such as grease, oil, paints, varnish, fiber, coal tar, etc. So these are the rusting of iron along with corrosion prevention. Okay, how will you protect prevent corrosions. Okay, so that is very important. We should practice and practice again and again. You should know the reactions, rusting of irons. You also know the formula Fe2O3 6 water. We also have seen that schematically presentations or diagram for rusting of iron. Next, corrosion prevention continues part 5. Layer of backfill. For example, limestone with underground piping metal purifications. 6, alloying. 7, cathodic protections. Number 8, coating. Number 9, by using inhibitors. Number 10, by proper designing. Number 11, by using non-metal materials. And 12, sacrificial anodes. So these are the corrosion prevention. Again I tell you, layer of backfills. For example, limestone with underground piping metal purifications, alloy and cathodic protection and metallic coating, and by using inhibitors, and by proper designing, and by using non-metallic character and sacrificial anodes. So these are the corrosion prevention. In this way, we are using this topic, okay, we can remove corrosions. Okay, so now sacrificial anodes. Okay, utilization of metal lower on the galvanic series to be attracted first. Utilization of metal lower on the galvanic series to be attracted first instead of metal in use. That sacrificial anodes can be replaced as needed. Passivations. Some corrosion process will create solid metal components. Some corrosion process will create solid metal compounds that will coat initial site of corrosions and prevent further corrosion at the site. Cathodic protections. In the illustrations below, the iron is coated with thin layer of zinc, which is acting as a sacrificial layer of the iron. So instead of iron corroding, zinc acts as a sacrificial anode in the fuel and protects the iron. So similarly, metallic coating, it involves coating of metals on iron. Different types of metallic coatings are, first, that is metal coating. We know through metal coating we can protect the corrosions. First is galvanizing. So galvanizing and electroplating, these are the very important. So it is the coating of thin film of zinc on iron. Tinning or tin plating, coating of iron metals by pigment heat in a bath of molten tin and then passed through rollers to the remove excess tin. What I have told you, it is the coating of thin film of zinc on the iron, thinning of tin plating, coating of the tin on iron metal, may be dipping, okay, it in bath of molten tin and then passed through the rollers to the remove excess tin. Okay, now electroplating. It is the coating of copper, nickel, chromium on iron with the aid of direct electric current. shredded zinc. It consists in zinc dust powder on the surface of iron to be protected and heating the metal until zinc metals 350 to 370 degree centigrade and forms coating of zinc iron alloy on the surface. Cladding. It is the covering of metal surface with a thin layer of aluminium or other corrosion resistance metal. Clad steel means steel with protective covering. Steel with protective covering. They are used in making processing equipment for chemical, food, oil industry, etc. So, how to prevent the corrosions? I have already explained 12 points. So, first, these are the, use of non-corrosive metals. Make sure the surface stays clean and dry. Use of coating or barrier products such as grease, oil, paint, varnish, etc. Similarly, sacrificial anodes, passivations, cathodic protections, metallic coating, galvanizing, electrochemical, seal, redesigning, and cladding. So, these are the very important for how to prevent a corrosion, also very important rusting of iron. So, next move on the slide. Paints, varnish, oils, grease, coltha. So, we have seen that in our house or village area, so those are poor, what will happen? They will use the coltha. Okay, and you use grease or oils, etc., in your cycle, motorcycle, and car, etc. So, they are used to protect metal surface from the corrosive effects of weather, heat, and moisture. Okay. Next, inhibitors. Selected chemicals are added to the corrosion medium which stop the anodic and cathodic reactions. Selective chemicals are added to the corrosion medium which stop the anodic and cathodic reactions. They are also known as corrosion inhibitors. Anodic inhibitors are oxygen and oxidizing agent. As for example, sodium chromate, which is used in air conditions and refrigeration systems, automobile indicators, power plant condensers, and similar equipment, sodium nitrate is also used for the protection of petroleum pipelines. So, that is the inhibitors. Cathodic inhibitors means these are common compounds like bicarbonates, calcium bicarbonate, sodium phosphate, okay. In aqueous solution, these deposit films on metal surface by reactions with cathodic alkali provide effective physical and protection against corrosive attack. Non-metallic character, sheet lying or thick covering of impermeable non-metallic materials which are the affected by corrosive materials have often been used to protect metal surface from corrosions. So, these materials are of different types. First one is carbon and graphite. Number two, ceramics such as stoneware, porcelain, fused silica, glass, bricks, mortar, cement, etc. So, these are the carbon and graphite and ceramics. So, stoneware, porcelain, fused silica, glass, bricks, mortar, etc. Now, number three, plastic such as phenolics, vinyls, polyethylene, acrylene, nylon and silicones. So this type of compounds should be taken to be consideration. Okay. Number 4 is natural and synthetic rubber. Number 5 is wood. So first one, carbon and graphite. Number 2, oil, ceramics such as stoneware, porcelain, fused silica, glass, bricks, mortar, cement, etc. These are the ceramics such as this one. Okay, and fused silica, glass, bricks, mortar, cement, etc. Plastics such as phenolics, vinyls, polythene, acrylic, nylon and silicones. And natural and synthetic rubber and wood. So these are the materials of different types. Proper designing of metal component also decrease corrosions. Moisture is an important participant in the electrochemical corrosions. Three components I told you: water, metals and electrolyte. So now impact of corrosions. The annual worldwide cost of metallic corrosion is estimated to be over $2 trillion, yet experts believe 25 to 30% could be prevented with proper corrosion protections. Poorly planned construction projects can lead to corrected structure needed to be replaced, which is waste of natural resource and contradictory to global concerns over sustainability. In addition, corrosion can lead to safety concerns, loss of life, additional indirect cost and damage to reputation. So what I am told you, these are the how to prevent. Okay. As I told you, paints, varnish, oils, inhibitors, okay, anodic inhibitors, cathodic inhibitors, okay, then non-metallic materials, which also includes carbon and graphite, ceramics such as soft air, porcelain, fused silica and glass, brick, mortar and cement, and natural and synthetic rubber, also wood. Okay, now proper designing of the metal component also decreases corrosions. Moisture is an important participant in the electrochemical series. Effect of corrosions: annual worldwide cost of metallic corrosion is estimated to be over $2 trillion, yet experts believe 25 to 35% could be prevented. So corrosion, what is corrosions, cause of corrosions, as I told you. Okay, next, types of corrosions and also difference between chemical corrosion, electrochemical corrosion, and also the rusting of iron. This reaction also very important, along with this schematic diagram how corrosion is formed. Okay, so that is also very important. Rusting of iron is chemical reactions. Okay, and corrosion preventions: use of non-corrosive metals, use of coating barrier, make sure the material surface. Okay, next is layer of backfill of cathodic protections, alloying, metal purifications, metallic coating by using inhibitors, by proper designing and by using non-metallic materials and sacrificial anodes. We have already discussed sacrificial anodes, cathodic protections, galvanizing, electroplating, cladding. We also discuss paints, varnish, oils. So this is very important chapter for rusting of irons and chemical and electrochemical corrosions, their reactions, okay, and cause of corrosions and prevention, how to prevent these corrosions, and also effect of corrosions in society. Okay, so huge damage due to corrosion, there will be huge damage, which also leads to decrease in economic conditions. So that's why we can protect or minimize the corrosion effect particularly in rainy seasons. Okay, so I hope you are enjoying this video. Thank you for watching this video.